The Night Owl Show, next on Channel 6.
Yesterday, over at the Zen Art Center in Mount Tremper, two students approached me to be taught the flute. One of them was, as I understood, an internationally famous poet, quite an old man. And he asked me that when he plays his flute, various delusions and hallucinations and thoughts appear, and he plays his flute out through those delusions and thoughts. And what should I do about it? And so I answered him, when you're playing the flute, why are there necessarily such delusions? So actually I figured out that this person was talking about something else. I told him that he is playing the flute with his mouth, but his body is going somewhere else. And I told him that what we are doing, the way we are living, is not something that is to be talked about. It is something that is to be actually lived. So I said to this fellow, I bet when you sit in front of a plate of food, you are not deluded. And so why are you deluded when you pick up a flute? Are you deluded when you eat, or when you sleep, or when you go to the bathroom? If you're so deluded, then take your flute and hit yourself over the head. If you can't hit your own self over the head, give me the flute and I'll hit you over the head. And so he said that he had not come here to ask Doso Roshi to do that. So then Doso Roshi said, shut up. That person had come from New York the day before and stayed overnight at the Zen Art Center. Being internationally famous for him was nothing. This person had written poems, but all of these poems were surely nothing but deluded words. He walked away from that interview unable to look this way or that way and unable to see what was around him. And so I think that probably he was even more deluded then when he went back to New York City.
Thank you. that
Rolling Stone! I love Rolling Stone. New York, Philadelphia, Tokyo, same heart. Hey, rock and roll!
Mick Jagger gave me a dollar gratuity. That's what Mick Jagger gave me.
This is Don McLeese in the middle of JFK Stadium in Philadelphia, surrounded by about 90,000 rabid rock and roll fans, having a wonderful time out here. This is the second day of the Rolling Stones North American tour. Kicked off yesterday with a show that drew another 90,000. Journey appears to be starting right behind me just now. The Stones will be out in about 3 hours.
I've been driving cab in Philadelphia 15 years. When the Stones come in, the people get the fever for music because they don't get enough of it. And the Stones, they just turn everybody on. People need turning on. And when the Stones come in, they turn them on. They get the fever for them. I'd like to go down there myself. But duty calls.
I've had the, I took the Allman Brothers from from the airport to the Latham Hotel. I took Kiss from 30th Street to the Spectrum. I had Gene Pitney, I took him from 30th Street to the Franklin Motor Inn. I took Hugh Masekela from the airport to the Franklin Motor Inn, then to the Bellevue Stratford. I've had Henry Fonda in my cab. I took him to the Hilton. I caught a Colbert. She went from the Barclay to the Lotus Theater. In front of the Sheraton, and this young girl who looked like Twiggy walked over to me and said to me, "Is your cab for hire?" I said, "Yes." They had their Cadillac there, but what they did, they couldn't get in their Cadillac. They jumped in my cab, and I took them over to the Lotus Inn in Chinatown. That's where he went to have a late night snack. He tipped me. He gave me $1. He gave me a dollar tip. David Suskind, he tips. Vic Damone tips. Graham Kerr, the Albin Gourmet, he tips. Aretha Franklin does not tip. that's a fact. Paul Anka gave me $10. He was the biggest tipper. Out of the celebrities in the political field, I had Thomas E. Dewey that ran for president. He was in my cab. He gave me a $4.15 tip on an 85-cent ride.
Good evening. Welcome to Difficult Listening Hour, the spot on your dial for that relentless and impenetrable sound of difficult music. So sit bolt upright in that straight back chair, button that top button, and get set for some difficult music. Oola. 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 I came home today, and I opened the door with my bare hands, and I said, "Hey, who tore up all my wallpaper samples? Who ate all the grapes? The ones I was saving?" And this guy was sitting there. And I said, "Hey, pal, what's going on here?" And he had this smile. And when he smiled, he had these big white teeth, like luxury hotels on the Florida coastline. And when he closed his mouth, it looked like a big star. And I said to myself, "Holy smokes, looks like some kind of guest-host relationship to me." And I said, "Hey, pal, what are you doing here anyway? Who are you?" And he said, "Now, I'm the soul doctor. And you know, language is a virus from outer space. And hearing your name is better than seeing your face."
That is the way of breathing with the eye breath.
Good evening. We're at the Hudson Valley Mall, the latest addition to Mercantile Ventures in Kingston in, several weeks. And Jamie's here today. She shops here regularly, may I say? She's a regular. She knows this place like the back of her hand, don't you?
Yes.
What are the best stores here to shop in?
For clothes, Barbara Morris is a nice store.
80 stores.
Well, personally, I'm glad there's a mall in Kingston.
Excuse me.
This is fun.
My name is Robert Munroe. We're
Thank
from Channel
you.
6. You're welcome. Yeah. And do you like the mall?
Very nice, sir.
Is it? It's nice?
Definitely. I'm from New York, and we're up here for a few days. I think it's very nice.
Uh-huh. Could you come over here for a second so we can get a better view of you? There. That's much better. Is it easy shopping? I mean,
yes,
do you find that
is.
Everything is there that you need?
Very nice. We were in Hester's store. It's very lovely.
Uh-huh.
And these ladies purchased some articles, and we had a nice lunch in there. Very nice.
Do you think it's a nice addition to the Kingston area?
Yes, I certainly do.
The design of the mall is such that people are actually kept inside. There's virtually no way to get from one point to another outdoors without crossing over ravines and large boulders and large, dusty, windy landscapes, barren, devoid of any form of life. Well, I certainly feel like going out and buying to my heart's content after that rousing rendition of Shopper's Spree Blues.
Lean, low, and raring to go. The 1958 Edsel. You can see its distinctively different lines. You can feel its tremendous response on the road. Cruising, pulling, climbing. You'll discover the magnificent ability of the world's newest and finest V8 engines. The big new Edsel 475 and Edsel 400. These high compression, high torque engines are just one of many things that make driving an Edsel an experience you'll never forget. You'll shift while both hands stay at the wheel. You'll feel the superb handling ease of this beautifully engineered automobile. You'll discover the wonderful feeling of actually riding on air with new Edsel air suspension. Your Edsel dealer invites you to take a demonstration drive. And remember, of all the medium-priced cars, car for car across the board, the 1958 Edsel is the one that's new and the lowest priced, too.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, this is just a toy.
The Night Owl Show, Fridays at midnight on Channel 6. Channel 6 concludes its programming day with our national anthem.